And over to Gretch we go.
Thank you, Steve. As we just told you, the Senate expected to pass the tax cut deal when they vote early this week. The president, hoping the Senate's likely passage, opens the door to compromise among House Dems who rejected the plan last week. But there is no guarantee. So have House Dems become the new party of no, some are asking. Our Washington insiders join me for this debate. Ned Ryan, founder and president of American Majority, and Neera Tanden, COO of the Center for American Progress and former healthcare advisor to Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius. Good morning to both of you.
Morning.
Good morning.
Ned, will the Democrats become the party of no?
You know what? I don't think so. I think at the end of the day, after all their belly aching and complaining about this bill, I don't think they're going to be left with many options. I think there will be a vote. As Chris Van Hollen said yesterday on Fox News Sunday, there's going to be a vote and it will probably pass.
Mm-hmm. Neera, were you surprised at the comments by Chris Van Hollen yesterday? Because Paul Ryan, the Republican, seemed to be surprised on the television screen that it looked like Van Hollen was going to try and encourage other Dems to pass this thing.
Well, I think what I heard Chris Van Hollen say is that he wants to have a vote on every aspect of this bill, have a vote really on the estate tax portion, which costs $20 billion for a handful of families. I think that's legitimate. But then at the end of the day, I think there'll be a vote on the overall bill and they'll move forward. But for those who are concerned about transparency, having a vote on the estate tax seems reasonable.
Let's take a look at some of the scenarios now that are being posed for today. Here's scenario number one. The Senate passes the deal, which everyone expects. The House amends and sends back for approval. So, Ned, that's different from the House amends it, which is scenario number two, and gridlock ensues. Do you think there will be any amending going on?
Oh, absolutely. I think there will be. I think that's one of the interesting scenarios that could take place. You know, if this bill actually will come to a vote, I think it will. Just knowing how politics works and that the Dems actually, you know, when you say, are the Dems going to be a party of no, they should stop complaining and run with this bill. It's the best they're going to get before the Republicans take back the House. So right. I think they're going to want to push it through as quickly as possible, the Dems are.
I mean, Neera, isn't it quite clear that the Republicans have said that they're not going to really budge on anything else? So what would Democrats ask for that they would expect would pass?
Well, I think really there's a lot of anger about some provisions. And so there's going to be, I think the House will try and have a vote on the estate tax provision. And if Republicans want to vote against the bill simply because it doesn't have huge tax breaks for billionaires, then they can choose to do that. But at the end of the day, I think that will be sent to the Senate. They'll confer on it and then we'll go from there. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it's not like I don't think Democrats are going to hold up this bill.
Okay, interesting. So we have an agreement on that. Let's look at scenario number three. The Senate passes the deal. The House Dems agree to vote and then the president signs it into law. Ned, how much of a factor is the timing of everything right now? The fact that we're up against the Christmas season and also up against this deadline where the tax thing expires.
You know, Gretchen, what I would really love to see is Republicans, if they could, knowing that we need to extend these tax cuts to increase encourage capital investment into small business and job creation, I would actually like to see something take place in which Republicans say, let's have a straight up and down vote on the tax cuts. Mm-hmm. We'll deal with unemployment as well. But you know, the thing that's concerning me about this bill as I look more at it is some of the subsidies that are being added that have nothing to do with tax cuts.
Right. We discussed that last week, all of the earmarks. Neera, I want to give you one more comment on that, everything else that's been added to this bill.
I think some of the provisions are good ones. For energy tax credits, those are tax credits. They actually help create jobs. I think those are important provisions.
Think we're going to get agreement on between Ned and Neera, but I got to wrap it up there. Thanks, folks, for getting up so early on a Monday morning.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Coming up on the show, what would you consider?